Hello students, I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. In my previous lecture, I taught you chapter 4th of first flight, that is from the diary of Annie Frank. And today we are going to discuss its question answers and the next chapter of Footprints Without Feet, that is first chapter, A Triumph of Surgery.
This is class 10th, subject English, chapter 1, A Triumph of Surgery of Footprints Without Feet. And this is my lecture number 1. The topics that today we are going to cover are first, introduction of this chapter, next, summary of the chapter, next is chapter highlights, and then we will discuss new words. And after this, we will discuss our previous chapter solution. That chapter was from the diary of Annie Frank. So let us start with its introduction. A Triumph of Surgery by the renowned writer James Herriot is an interesting story of a small pet dog named Tricky. So the writer of this chapter is James Herriot, and he is the narrator of this chapter. Tricky's mistress, Mrs. Pumphrey, is a very rich woman who has pampered Tricky by overfeeding him. As a result of it, the dog has become seriously ill and abnormally fat. Therefore, the doctor tells Mrs. Pumphrey that her dog needs surgery. And ends up keeping the dog with him for a few days. So the narrator and the writer of this chapter is James Herriot, and he is a veterinary surgeon. And Tricky was a very small dog, and he was pampered and overfed by his rich mistress. Due to that, the dog has become seriously ill and he became abnormally fat. So therefore, the doctor was called. Doctor was James Herriot. So at last, Tricky was kept in surgery. Surgery is a place where a doctor treats or advises a patient. So there, the dog was kept, and after fortnight, he was transformed into a hard-muscled dog. Now, let us move to the summary of this chapter. Brief introduction of Tricky. Tricky was a small dog. He was pampered and overfed by his rich mistress. All of a sudden, he fell seriously ill. So, Mrs. Pumphrey consulted a veterinary surgeon. And this veterinary surgeon was James Herriot. James Herriot got anxious. James Herriot, a veterinary surgeon, was too anxious, too worried to see Tricky, because Tricky's condition was very bad. He was overweight, and his greed was the cause of his disease. He never learned to deny the food, to refuse the food. Tricky had become very fat. His eyes were red and rheumy. Rheumy means wet, watery. His tongue lolled from his jaw. Lolled means hair hung loosely. Means his tongue was hanging outside from his jaw. Mrs. Pumphrey thought that the dog was suffering from malnutrition. Malnutrition means poor nutrition. But actually, she was unaware about this, that she was overfeeding him. So she started giving him some extra. In extra, she gave him malt. Malt means barley. Cod liver oil. Cod liver oil means cod. Actually, it is a fish. And she started giving him cod liver oil and a bowl of Horlicks daily at night. But it did not work upon, because Tricky required exercise, but he didn't go for any exercise. He always kept on lying, and eating and eating. So due to this, he had become like a blotted sausage. Doctor's advice to Mrs. Pumphrey. Now doctor was called. So doctor advised Mrs. Pumphrey to cut down Tricky's food. Dr. James Harriet advised Mrs. Pumphrey to cut down Tricky's food. He told that Tricky should be given some exercises, otherwise he would become ill. And the same thing happened. Tricky fell ill. After a few days, Mrs. Pumphrey called on Dr. Harriet because Tricky fell seriously ill. He had not been eating for last 2 days and vomiting at regular intervals. He had not shown any interest in his surroundings. Tricky admitted to the hospital. Now James Harrier asked Mrs. Pumphrey to send Tricky with him in his surgery because according to Dr. Harriet, Tricky required treatment. Tricky was now admitted to the hospital. Everybody was in distress. Distress means in tension. At the surgery, the household dogs surged around Tricky. Means they were moving around Tricky. They moved around Tricky. For 2 days, he was only given plenty of water but no food. The actual problem with Tricky was overfeeding. And this was known to Mr. Harriet. So he knew the actual treatment of Tricky. So for 2 days in beginning, he did not give anything to eat to Tricky. No food was given to him. Tremendous progress in Tricky. Now there was a tremendous progress in Tricky in the hospital. A rapid progress in Tricky. After 2 days, there was tremendous progress in Tricky. He was not given any kind of medical treatment. Only he was given less food and more exercise. Mrs. Pumphrey was eager to know about his health. She kept on calling and inquiring about Tricky's health. She became very happy to know that Tricky was recovering. After this, she started sending round fresh eggs, bottles of wine, and even brandy to improve Tricky's health. Tricky was handed over to Mrs. Pumphrey. Now, at last, Tricky became an energetic dog from a lazy dog, inactive dog. And now, after getting cured, the doctor phoned her to tell that Tricky had recovered well and was awaiting collection. Tricky was handed over to her. At this, Pumphrey was very happy and she was very thankful to the doctor. Mrs. Pumphrey was very much thankful to Dr. Harriet. She had no words to express her gratitude. At last, she told the doctor that it was a triumph of surgery. Now, what is this triumph? Triumph means victory. So, according to her, this was a triumph of surgery because she thought Tricky was given a medical treatment or it was given medicinal treatment, but it was not such. So, according to her, it was a triumph of surgery. Now, let us move to chapter highlights. Tricky was a very small dog. He was pampered and overfed by his rich mistress. Next, the dog fell seriously ill. Mrs. Pumphrey consulted a veterinary surgeon for her dog, Tricky. This veterinary surgeon was the author of this chapter, James Harriet. Mrs. Pumphrey thought the dog lacks energy due to malnutrition, so he was given some little extras like malt, cod liver oil and a bowl of Horlicks. Tricky never refused anything to eat. He was always ready to take a meal at any hours. This was only his greed. That was the reason of his illness. He never refused food at any time. But now Tricky had not been eating anything for the last few days. He had bouts of vomiting The surgeon advised Mrs. Pumphrey to cut his food down and give him more exercise. But Mrs. Pumphrey could not do the same. But Tricky lay down now and he was panting and he did not go for walks. So Dr. Harriet was called by Mrs. Pumphrey. So he advised Mrs. Pumphrey for the hospitalization of Tricky for a fortnight to be kept under his supervision. She did not want to send Tricky because she thought that she could not live without Tricky, but she had to do the same because of her pet Tricky. Tricky was wrapped in a blanket and the entire staff were busy in bringing things for him. Now, what kind of things they were bringing? Actually, Tricky had different kinds of beds, different kinds of coats, toys, rings, and many more things at Mrs. Pumphrey's house. So they all started bringing things for him. At the surgery, the household dogs. Now, Tricky was in the hospital in surgery, and there the household dogs gathered around him and thought that he was an uninteresting object because at that time he was listless, he had no energy in him. That's why they all ignored him. For 2 days, Tricky was not given food but only plenty of water. And after 2 days, Tricky started showing some interest in his surroundings and began to whimper. Whimper means a low, weak cry a person or an animal makes when they are hurt, frightened, or sad. So he began to whimper when he heard the dogs in the yard. Next day, the doctor was very happy to see Tricky's activities. Happy to see Tricky jostling means running his way to food bowl. Now he was also eager to have something. There was much progress in Tricky. He was not given medical treatment of any kind and ran about with the dogs throughout the day. The doctor told her that Tricky was recovering rapidly. After hearing this news, Mrs. Pumphrey started arranging different kinds of food, wine, etc. That's why Mr. Harriet thought to keep Tricky as his permanent guest because all those things were enjoyed by Mr. Harriet and his partners like eggs, wine, and brandy. Later on, the doctor went to hand over the dog to Mrs. Pumphrey. It was really an amazing moment for her. Mrs. Pumphrey had no words to express her gratitude. She just said that it was a triumph of surgery. She told the doctor that it was the triumph of surgery. It was the victory of surgery. Now let us discuss some new words. Lumbago. It means muscular pain in the lower part of the back. Jostling. It means to push roughly against somebody in the crowd. Triumph. It means a great success. And next is relent. It means to agree upon something after refusing. Resign. It means prescribe course of exercise and diet. Next is distraught. It means extremely worried. Next is swooned. It means to become unconscious. Unconscious. Whimper. It means a low, weak cry of a person or an animal makes when they are hurt, frightened, or sad. Scrimmages. It means rough or confused struggle. Now your homework for this chapter is read the chapter thoroughly and find out the answers of textual questions given at page number 1 and 3 of Footprints Without Feet. Thank you. Now, let us move to next part of this lecture, that is homework solution of lecture 3. chapter number 4 from the diary of Annie Frank. So class 10, subject English, chapter 4 from the diary of Annie Frank, lecture number 3, homework solution. Question and answers. Question number 1. What makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Annie Frank? Writing in a diary was a strange experience for Annie Frank as she had never written before. She had never written anything before. She also thought that nobody would be interested in the musings of a 13 years old schoolgirl. Musings means thinking. But she was wrong. Question 2. This is, why does Annie want to keep a diary? Annie wanted to keep a diary because she didn't have a real friend. She didn't have a true friend. She wanted to share her feelings and thoughts with a real friend, but she didn't have. And she thought that the paper has more patience than people. That's why she wants to keep a diary. And she started writing a diary, and even she called her diary Kitty. Question number 3. Why did Annie think she could confide more in her diary than in people? Annie didn't have a true friend. There were many friends to whom she could call her friends, but she talked to them about day-to-day things. She didn't seem to get any closer to them. It may be her fault that she couldn't confide in them. She couldn't trust in them. She believes that paper has more patience than people. There were many friends of any friend, but she did not have a real friend, a true friend with whom she could discuss her personal experiences. So that's why she started writing a diary. Next question, why does Annie provide a brief sketch of her life? She provided a brief sketch of her life because she knew that no one would understand a word of her musings without knowing her whereabouts, without knowing about her family background. So that's why she gave a complete description of her family. What tells you that Annie loved her grandmother? Annie's grandmother had fallen seriously ill. Annie's birthday was even not celebrated because Annie's grandmother was ill. Grandmother died the next year and she missed her a lot. Even she wrote in her diary that no one knew how often she thought of her grandmother and still loved her. Question number 6. Why was Mr. Keesing annoyed with Annie and what did he ask her to do? Now, who was Mr. Keesing? Mr. Keesing was Annie's maths teacher. Annie was very talkative. Annie talked too much in the classroom. That's why she was punished by Mr. Keesing. She was assigned some extra homework. And that homework was assigned by Mr. Keesing. And she was asked to write an essay on the subject, a chatterbox. Chatterbox means a talkative person. So she wrote that essay. First essay was written. Then once again, she started talking. Then once again, she got one more essay to write. That essay was an incorrigible chatterbox. Incorrigible means that cannot be corrected. And at last, third time, she got one more essay to write. That was quack, 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 sad mistress chatterbox. She wrote all 3 essays and at last, she was allowed to speak in the classroom because she gave logics behind her habit of talking. Question number 7. How did Annie justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? In her first essay, she wrote that talking is a trait of a child and she had inherited that trait from her mother. So this is given. Annie wanted to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. Talking was a student's trait and she had inherited this trait from her mother. She was unable to cure herself of this habit. Question number 8. What made Mr. Keesing allow Annie to talk in the class? Annie was able to justify her talkative nature every time she was punished by Mr. Keesing. She was assigned extra homework. She was asked to write essay, first of all, a chatterbox, then an incorrigible chatterbox, and third time, quack, 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 said mistress, chatterbox, and she was able to justify her talkative nature every time she gave some logics. So at last, Mr. Keesing allowed Annie to talk in the classroom. The teacher gave her topics to write essays on three occasions. He was impressed by the manner in which she presented her arguments. Thank you.